Ladies and gentlemen, did you miss me? Welcome back for the first time to Let's Play Guitar Hero Van Halen. And in the last episode, we didn't have one. If anyone's wondering where I've been, I've had some personal things come up, and I was also have upgraded my setup to hopefully make some better quality videos. Well, similar quality videos, just easier for me, I guess, to make. Man, I've changed softwares. I still have the Roxio and everything, but I've been trying to learn this whole new way of doing things. I'm trying to modernize myself. I'm trying to set myself up for streaming, actually. And if anyone happened to catch the stream, the few streams, actually, that I did, I apologize for the quality. I was really trying to figure out exactly what my internet could or could not handle, how to set it up, adjust settings and whatnot. And unfortunately, I didn't accomplish anything. So I'm thinking about, I'm debating right now whether or not to upgrade my service provider, but you know, it comes at a cost of input latency, moving to satellite internet. I've just had a lot on my mind. There's been a lot of things, personal life going on. That's why I didn't start Van Halen earlier. I wanted to. I was thinking about it every day. I was wanting to do it, trying to find time to do it. We're here. So, man, so many things. Let's just get into it, man. This is Van Halen. Probably the most underrated Guitar Hero out there. Man, me and Architect, we play this game so much and have a great time every time. It's a little bit easier than Metallica, with the exception of a few songs, but I would say this arguably has the best soundtrack on any Guitar Hero. It's just good stuff, man. And I'm so excited to finally be doing it. Oh my god! You gotta love Eruption, man. Man, this game came out at such a controversial time in the band's career. God. Michael Anthony, unfortunately, did not make it. But at the same time, it's just as awesome that his son, Eddie's son Wolfgang, made it to the game. I am just, man, welcome. Gosh. My God, I can feel the copyright strikes now. Top down.
the road from the heat coming off. I reach down between my legs, ease the seat back.
Man, what a song to start it off with, huh? Van Halen's, like, number one. I mean, I don't know about the number one. I have a lot of Van Halen songs that occupy the number one spot in my mind. But, man, Panama is very classic. Early song I learned to play. Unfortunately, I don't have the proper strings on my guitar at the moment. But, man, I had to cut out the webcam. That was a big decision. As far as coming back to do this game, was to keep the webcam or not, because I have like a spare. I guess I might as well explain a little bit. The Xbox Live Vision camera is not exactly what I would call high resolution, and unfortunately Microsoft did not keep up on the drivers for Windows 10, and I guess any other Windows. I've never used the Vision camera with it. Unfortunately, it's not good enough. I hate to say it. I'd love to use it because it's kind of a cute little thing, and I love, you know, the Xbox and or Xbox 360. Grew up on it and whatnot, but it's just not really compatible with what I got going right now. But yeah, so I may cut out the whole guitar playing thing. You know, it's just I'm still getting used to all this too. I'd played a lot of. Like, try to set up the audio the way I wanted it to, and I still don't think it's the way it should be. I don't know if I'm loud enough. We'll find out when this video's over if I'm loud enough in relation to the game. Yeah, I'm happy to be back, man, playing some of the best songs ever. Man. But yeah, Michael Anthony, man, he was out of the band when this game came out. It's kind of a shame. Me and him have the same birthday, believe it or not. Boom, boom, boom. I remember that interview of Dave Mustaine talking about how he met Dave Evelston. I think Dave lived on the apartment above him, and Evelston, being a bass player, he was playing this song early one morning, and Dave had been drinking the night before. And this is how the interview goes. And he started out with an intro, boom, boom, boom. And Dave threw like a flower pot on his air conditioning unit or something. It's pretty funny. So every time I hear this song, I think of that. I need to start trusting my pinky, man. But I am so glad that David Lee Roth came in for this game. Like, they had it together, you know, just long enough to get Dave on this game. And they've since gone on tour with him, but it hasn't exactly turned out peachy. It's so simple, no. When I jumped out on that road, got Dang it, man. Yeah, I was very excited to have updated my setup. I'm using OBS now instead of Roxio, and it's still kind of weird, though, the way you got to do the capturing, because sometimes it doesn't really want to activate within OBS, and you have to, like, turn it on in Roxio, and while that's running, turn on OBS and activate it there. I mean, it's just kind of weird. I don't know if it's a driver situation or if a licensing, I don't know, but... Either way, we're here and we're doing it. And I noticed, like, as soon as I turned on this new computer, man, and I did, I checked out specs and compared it with what I had, and I made sure everything was better. Everything was top of the line, kind of, well, not top of the line, top of the line for what I need, which is really 1080p at 30 frames a second. As long as I had a computer that could handle that, I really didn't care. But, man, just because there was, like, glitches. Like, my old laptop computer could handle what I was doing, but it could not handle it very well. And there was glitches in all my videos, all my HD videos that I had. Like, I could tell, like, whenever I would start recording, it would kind of glitch out in the beginning, but then it would, you know, chill out, and then maybe somewhere halfway in the video would glitch out again. But it's like little visual glitches. As far as editing goes, it could not. I swear it took all the CPU that it had just to run the software, the Roxio software. And even then, I couldn't do it the right way. Well, this one, I made sure it was double, if not triple, everything else. So, yeah, I'm pretty excited. Unfortunately, I forgot to edit Casey? Do you ever agree if it was Casey or Cassie? Miss Lynch. I guess I have to do that next time. French Fry Helmet. That's the best name I could come up with. I couldn't come up with a name better than that. But yes, welcome. Welcome, everyone, to Let's Play Guitar Hero. And, man, it is on. It is so on with Billy Idol, First Date. Oh, man, Safe Your Room at Home. Hopefully, we probably can't do all these. We're halfway through. But, oh, God, I'm so happy to be here. Happy to be back. I hope it works out. Even though I did some test runs and it seemed okay. I don't know if it is though. We'll find out. But I missed you guys a great deal. And man, this new setup. One of the things I'm most excited about is I have officially been able to cut out editing. That's so much easier than on Rock Band. Well, if I'd actually not watched my other screen. I could probably get hit the notes, you know. I am a little rusty too, ladies and gentlemen, so you're gonna have to bear with me on that. I haven't really played Guitar Hero since the last video we recorded. It's a nice day for a white wedding.
It's a nice day to start again. Hey, little sister, who is it your way? Hey, little sister, what's your bicep wish? Hey, little sister, shotgun on. Sister, who's your Superman? Hey, little sister, shotgun. It's a nice day to start again. It's a nice day for a white wedding. It's a day to start again. Ow.
I love Billy Idol so much, man. This song is amazing. So what I'm thinking is, because this computer has a lot more guts, I bought a tower instead of a really powerful laptop. I had the room and it didn't really matter. I didn't need portability. So I tried to get the best stuff I could get. I think I got I got the manual right here. It's a Dell Vostro 3471. And it's, so I memorized the specs. Compared to what I had, I think I had a dual core processor at, I don't know, it was around 3 or 2.7 gigahertz. I don't know. Can't remember exactly. And it only had like 6 or 8 gigs of RAM, my old laptop. Well, this one, I wanted to go overboard. Okay, so keep that in mind compared to what, it's not some high-end gaming PC with the best graphics card and all this other thing, but it's a 6-core processor at 4.1 gigahertz with 32 gigs of RAM DDR4. I don't know the difference between DDR4 and DDR3. And it's got solid state drive. I think it's like 250 gigs solid state drive and a terabyte of hard drive space. And it had something else that the other one didn't have. Well, obviously, probably a better graphics card, but the graphics card wasn't really the issue. I needed more processing power at the end of the day. That's what it comes down to. Fortunately, editing software uses more CPU than GPU, I would say, most of the time. I don't really want to get into an argument because I'm not big on computers like some people are, but from what I read online, software capture was more heavily influenced by the CPU, so I needed to have something grandiose, I guess, of that. And so far I've really felt the performance change, and thankfully OBS, my old computer, it couldn't even run Roxio on OBS, and this one, I haven't had a problem with it. I've done test runs, but the coolest thing that OBS has is the ability to delay, like, my mic from the game audio while it's recording, which is amazing. I know everybody else has been living in the 21st century except for me. So the ability to do that cuts out all that editing time that I would otherwise have to do in Roxio software. So that kind of encourages me to just hotkey start and stop to my keyboard here. And that's, like, it just makes things 1,000 times easier. So I'm more inclined now to, like, let's say if I get off early on a Monday or a Tuesday or something, to just record, like, nonstop, which makes me very happy. That's on blink, man. Let's go! Yeah, man, like this game has songs like this, Billy Idol. It's got, who else? It's got Semi-Charmed Life on here. It's got Tenacious D on here. Like, man, all the Van Halen songs. I wish they would have gotten some stuff from Sammy Hagar, though. There's a few songs off of Best of Both Worlds, the Greatest Hits album, that I wish they would have made it on here. I don't know why they couldn't get anything worked out with Sammy. They may have had something going on between, like, bringing Dave back or, I don't know the finer details. I just know that the core of Van Halen being Eddie and Alex have never really, they haven't found that that perfection in a singer. I mean, I always thought David Lee Roth was a lot better than Sammy. Well, not better, just different, and he fit Van Halen better. No offense to Sammy. He's a legend in his own right, but... You know. We got the Clash on here, dude. Jeez. I haven't seen them since what? Did they have a song on World Tour, or were they just on... Aerosmith. It's like he's going, man. Oh man, why would they give you star power at the end of that? Man, that's about it for this first episode. Hope everybody enjoyed it. Sorry if it's a little boring. Sorry I had to axe the webcam. At some point I might get a better one. It really doesn't matter. I mean, well, maybe it does. Maybe it does matter. Maybe before this Let's Play is over, I'm sure USB webcams are not that expensive. But as long as it's modern, it needs to be very compatible with Microsoft and Windows 10, I guess, and everything that's going on there. It doesn't need to be easily outdated. But yeah, I don't have a problem hooking one up. The laptops I had before had built-in web cameras, so it wasn't really a problem, and now it's either really bad quality or nothing, and I would just rather have nothing for the time being. But thank you for watching, and keep it real, keep it new. I'll see you cats, kittens in the next episode. It's an absolute pleasure. Keep it real. And